Hello. I saw a question online earlier. What is the best way to maintain good health in middle age? Someone condensed it into a 9-character mantra: don't overdraw, don't be demanding, don't compare. Indeed, as we reach a certain age, we should learn to make choices in life. Today, I will share with you the most advanced way to maintain health in late age, which is neither exercise nor sleep. We need to simplify in order to live more clearly. When we were young, we always hoped to return with full hands, fill our rooms, pile up our lives, and hoard our hearts. It wasn't until we reached middle age that we realized that the moon wanes as it waxes. When you have too many unimportant things in your heart, it not only won't make you better, but it will also make your heart increasingly anxious and empty. In the second half of life, learning to subtract from the heart can bring back the simplicity and richness you've been missing. Clear your mind of distractions, and then your heart can be calm. I once saw a question online: what is the root cause of a person's suffering? A highly upvoted answer said that there is always a harsh judge within, demanding perfection in everything. If you fail to meet those standards, you become anxious, unbalanced, and deeply troubled. The fastest way to ruin a person is to make them pursue perfection. It's a law of nature that excessive effort doesn't lead to great distances, and chasing perfection often results in a life full of flaws. I recall reading a post online about someone who, due to years of extreme self-criticism, was diagnosed with late-stage cancer at the age of 40. Reflecting on their first half of life, the author shared a poignant thought: I used to be the kind of person who lived every day and every hour very logically and efficiently. I demanded perfection in every aspect, and I never wasted time. But now, if I could live again, I wouldn't deliberately pursue perfection, I wouldn't be so cruel to myself, I would be a little more confused in handling life, not so shrewd. I would rest more and learn to go with the flow. In early spring, I would go to the countryside to enjoy nature, and when the sun sets, I would take my child to ride the carousel. As we reach middle age, we understand that life doesn't require grand ceremonies. The essence of happiness lies in inner contentment and tranquility. Life is like a play. There's no need to demand a flawless performance from ourselves. Sometimes it's fine to just admire the distant high mountains, and it's liberating to let go of things beyond our reach. Giving up the pursuit of perfection and making peace with our ordinary selves is a mark of maturity. Let go of complaints to find inner peace. I once read a statement online: complaining is a very negative behavior. It satisfies your mouth, but provides excuses for your mediocrity and doesn't change your situation. In real life, people who constantly complain are not necessarily malicious. It's just that deep down they are dissatisfied, and changing their current situation is difficult, so they rely on complaints to vent their emotions. Over time, their hearts are filled with negativity. Complaining is not a solution. It won't permanently solve problems. The more you indulge in grievances, the more you sink and lose more. Instead of complaining in the dark, it's better to move forward with a lighted lamp. Life is repeatedly trampled by complaints. Only by treating it with a calm and optimistic attitude can life respond with joy. Detach from expectations to find inner peace. There's a question online: what is the root of a person's suffering? A highly upvoted answer below states: high expectations, excessive desires, and premature giving up. Thinking carefully, it's often true. Having high expectations of people and things, having excessive desires for fame and wealth, and giving up on life too early are the fundamental reasons for our suffering. The writer model once said something: I gradually understood why I wasn't happy, because I always expected a certain outcome. Much of our suffering in life doesn't come from life's trials, but from our high expectations of people and things. Just like me back then, I always expected others to be as honest and open as I was to them, without reservation. But I forgot that others might not necessarily reciprocate in the same way. They were just making choices after weighing the pros and cons, not a definitive declaration that I was indispensable. My disappointment, my sadness, and even my self-hatred were all self-inflicted. Can I blame others for not holding me in high regard? Definitely not. I can only blame myself for overestimating my position in their hearts. If I hadn't had expectations in the first place, I wouldn't have been so hurt later on. The higher our expectations, the greater the disappointment. Lowering expectations is the wisest choice. In late age, taking care of the heart is more important than taking care of the body. Francis Bacon once said, "A healthy body is a guest chamber for the soul, a sick body is a prison." The path to health requires the well-being of the body, emotions, and soul. Therefore, only by cultivating a strong physique, positive emotions, and a rich inner world can we reap a fulfilling and healthy life. Health comes from nurturing the heart. Research by the World Health Organization found that 90% of diseases are related to emotions because prolonged exposure to negative emotions depletes your willpower. We often think that staying healthy means going to bed and waking up early, taking nutritional supplements. However, have you noticed that many people who talk about health or adhere to health practices sometimes don't end up healthier than others? People who often drink herbal tea or prioritize sleep, if they have a bad temper, still suffer from stress. People who advocate early bedtimes and early rises, if they have bottled up emotions, can still feel mentally foggy. It's evident that the best way to maintain health is not through formalism or external adjustments to the body, but by maintaining good emotional health and a healthy mindset. External care is only supplementary. True health starts from within. To be truly healthy, we need to start from within. Health comes from nurturing the heart. Only when we cultivate a healthy heart and place ourselves in a relaxed and joyful living environment can we fundamentally solve our problems. Let's encourage each other, my friends. Alright, we will conclude this video here. If you found my video enjoyable, please subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video.